Hi everybody, Mike Rebarczyk.
And Candice Rebarczyk.
Life Realty, the Rebar team. And we wanted to go ahead and make a quick video on something that's been pretty much plaguing the Las Vegas and Henderson real estate market for a few years now.
Yeah, low inventory on homes, so.
Yeah, there's not enough supply to keep up with the demand of home ownership. And so I know a lot of buyers are out there
just struggling, frustrated.
Very frustrating. You're trying to buy the American dream and you're not having any luck. You're being turned down left and right. Every house you're offering on has multiple offers. However, Candice and I have had our busiest month and I think record setting.
Yeah.
So we've obviously found the secret. We're doing something right. And we wanted to share some of the tidbits that we know with you.
They're helping our clients get homes.
Get homes in this tight inventory. Things that are hurting your chances of being a homeowner in this tight market.
Not working with an experienced agent. You need an experienced agent. They know what the market's doing. They know how to react to it. They know that it moves quickly. They got to get you into the home. If it's vacant, we're going to go see it now. If it needs an appointment, we're going to make that appointment as soon as possible because that's what other experienced agents are doing. And if you don't have that, then you don't have a chance.
That's right. Number two that could be hurting your chances, not giving and taking with some of your criteria. Obviously, everybody wants a certain size square footage, number of beds, baths. There's some things that you can't really adjust too much on. School zones, you want to be in a certain school zone. But
be open to
a house that might need a little bit of updating, you know, so it doesn't have granite countertops, but has everything else.
Maybe the square footage is a little less than you wanted, but until you go see a home, you know, the layout might work just fine for you.
Exactly. So. Yep, that happens quite a bit. The floor plan, working with clients that maybe are, you know, saying adamantly, needs to be 2,500 square feet or more. Criteria, it needs to be adjusted. Maybe we go to 2,350 or 2,400. What do you know? They fall in love with the house. So that was something that without a little bit of give and take, we would have never been able to see.
So number three, another thing that can hurt your chances is not being pre-approved for your loan and not knowing your buying power. I mean, this is the start of the whole process. If you don't know your buying power, then why are you out there looking? So before you come to us, get pre-approved, find a lender. If you don't have a lender, give us a call. We can give you some options. And
Yeah, well, and it's not just your buying power, like Candice was saying. It's also finding out what comfortable payment you're at. You might be pre-approved up to $300,000, but if you don't like the payment that's associated with $300,000, then we need to scale that down. When we submit offers, we include the pre-approval with our offers, so that way the seller and the seller's agent know that you're ready to go, you're pre-approved. In fact, we actually even pick up the phone when we submit the offer to the listing agent and recommend and encourage them to contact your loan officer so they hear it straight from the horse's mouth that you are ready to buy, you've been pre-qualified or pre-approved, you're ready to go, you just need to find a house. So number four would basically not have a strategy in place after reviewing comps and figuring out what you're going to offer on a house. So we're really big on running the comparables or the comps. We treat it just like an appraiser would. We don't go to Zestimate. We actually pull up the comps ourselves, review them, come up with a proper strategy to get a house. Right now you're seeing a lot of homes go over list price so we could secure them. But it's not worth the paper it's written on if we know it's not going to appraise, right? If we go over a list just to get it and the appraisal comes in less, we need to renegotiate or maybe you have to come out of pocket above the appraised amount in order to get the house. So that's something that, again, needs to be factored in. If the house is worth $300, don't go in at $305 if it's only going to appraise at $299 or $297 or
$98. Well, and that's where the experienced agent's going to guide you to the correct, you know,
and
strategy. Best way to do it. So
that's right, because you know, on renegotiating on something like that, you're already in your home inspection cost, which is typically $300 to $350 or more, depending on the house size.
An appraisal fee.
$500. So you've already invested close to $1,000 to find out that just to get a house you over purchased, then the appraisal's not going to come in. You're not going to be too happy with an unexperienced agent.
But we're not going to do that to you.
Of course not.
Your money is our money. We treat it. You know, we don't want you to lose that $800. That'd be the worst thing. So
yeah.
We're going to be upfront about that in the beginning, and we're going to talk to the listing agent. We're going to
really do our due diligence to make sure you're not overpaying for a house as tight as the market is.
Correct.
Another thing that's hurting your chance of home ownership, number five.
Not moving quick enough. if you're in the market to buy a home, we got to do it. We got to move quickly. We got to write the offer. We got to get it to that listing agent because everybody else is doing it. And if you're thinking about it, you're most likely going to lose in this market right now.
That's right. There's a reason why we carry the purchase agreements and comps for a particular house that we're going to show you. We write offers on the trunk of our cars if we have to. It's that kind of market. We can't wait. We used to be able to tell clients, sleep on it, see if you feel it, you know, like house hunters or something. In this market, we might not have that opportunity. If the house has been on the market a couple days and they're presenting 4, 5, 6 offers that night, and here it is at 1 in the afternoon, there's a reason why, again, we carry that agreement with us and we're ready to rock and roll, writing them handwritten if we have to on the trunk of our car to get that offer in and give us the best chance to get it.
So, number 6.
Not making your best offer. It doesn't mean you have to go above list or anything like that, but I want you to feel comfortable on an offer that we're making that you could say, you know, I could sleep at night knowing I gave it my best shot. We adjusted the criteria, you were loving the home, but it wasn't your dream home. So if we got it for the right price that you wanted to offer and something that's based on the comps, great. If not, hey, no problem. We drew the line in the sand. That was our best offer. But you want to go ahead and come real strong. This isn't the market where if something's priced at $300,000, you could go and offer $280,000 because odds are the other 4 or 5 offers are probably higher than $280,000. Number 7 tidbit to help
is not being scared of the inspection report. You know, not every home is perfect. Truthfully, not even a brand new home is perfect. There's going to be things wrong, and as you're living there, there's things you're going to have to do to fix it. But the inspection report can seem scary. It's 50 pages. It gives a summary of all these negative things or just maintenance things, and maybe it seems overwhelming. But, you know, really take a step back, look at it, and don't let it scare you away. Because sometimes it's just a fixer-upper. You just need a little bit of elbow grease, and who can't do that?
That's right. And we, as experienced agents, actually show up to the home inspection with our clients the last 10 to 15 minutes because, like Candace mentioned, that 50-page home inspection report can make it look like the sky is falling and the house is unstable. Really, the home inspection is meant to show the major things that could be found in the house.
You're going to see wear and tear.
Yeah. I mean, so we help you come up with a remedy or a strategy to go back to the seller and say, hey, we need this address, or this address. Occasionally, something is so large that even if the seller were to remedy it, it's not up to your choosing or your liking, and we cancel the deal, move on. Perfectly fine. We cancel it. No harm done.
Okay, so last one, number 8.
Would be to not have the right mindset. So we put in an offer. You're already picking out where you're going to put your furniture. You're real excited, and come to find out one of the other 4, 5, 6 offers that they received
was chosen
for whatever the reason. Obviously, we can't get into it too much, but we figured it's something to do with the price or what we're offering. No problem. You have to have the right mindset.
Yeah,
that's where an encouraged or an agent that would be basically encouraging would step in and say, hey, no problem. Everything happens for a reason. We'll find the next one. And believe it or not, homes that are in contract do fall out of contract.
Yep.
For a variety of reasons. Maybe the buyer didn't like something on that home inspection, wanted to go ahead and walk and cancel the deal.
And you might get a second chance at it.
That's right. That's why we recommend that we always stay as a backup offer in the event that something like that happens. Maybe the buyer's financing fell through. Maybe the cash of funds or the proof of funds for the cash offer weren't really proof of funds for that cash offer. So there's a variety of reasons. That's why we stay encouraged. Everything happens for a reason.
There's going to be another house.
That's right. We're going to pick you up. Move on to the next house.
Yes.
So hopefully these 8 tips help you navigate through the home buying process and the shortage of inventory here in Southern Nevada.
Yep. Thanks for tuning in. We'll be back.
Yeah. Contact us if we could help. Thanks.